Hello, good morning. Myself, I am BSR Botany Lecturer. Today our topic, fruits. You know, the fruits are developed from ovary. After fertilization, ovary developed into fruit. Ovules are developed into seeds. Generally, the fruits are two types, false fruits and true fruits. True fruits are developed from the ovary, whereas false fruits are developed from other floral parts but along with the ovary. False fruits are developed from other floral parts but along with the ovary. Example, when you take in apple, Pyrus malus, in which false fruit is present and true fruit is also present. Clearly, false fruit developed from thalamus, true fruit developed from ovary. And one more example, when you go Anacardium. In Anacardium, true fruit, their ovary, the ovary developed into true fruit, whereas the pedicel developed into false fruit, that is very fleshy. So that is a false fruit. Then we are going to true fruits. These true fruits are three types: simple, aggregated and compound fruits. Simple, aggregate and compound fruits. Simple fruits are developed from single flower. Simple fruits are developed from single flower, but clearly from Syncarpus gynoecium. Syncarpus means all the carpels are fused. Whereas aggregate fruits, in aggregate fruit also, the fruits are developed from single flower but from Apocarpus gynoecium. Apocarpus gynoecium means that the carpels are free. Each carpel developed into fruitlet. Example, you take custard apple, that each one is a fruitlet. Okay, each carpel is a fruitlet. So there all carpels are free. Each carpel developed into fruitlet. All fruitlets constitute to form a aggregate fruit. So aggregate fruits are developed from single flower but from Apocarpus gynoecium. Example, Annona. Then we go for compound fruits. Compound fruit developed from entire inflorescence and also its components. You take jackfruit. In the jackfruit, each flower parts are developed into fruit. So the compound fruit developed from entire inflorescence. Example, jackfruit and also pineapple. Then you go for simple fruits in detail. Simple fruits are two types, fleshy fruits and dry fruits. Fleshy fruits I am taking. Fleshy fruit, example, mango and coconut. Just you take the mango. Fleshy fruit means that the fruit wall is called pericarp. The fruit wall is called pericarp when the pericarp is differentiated into outer epicarp, middle mesocarp and inner endocarp. When fruit wall called pericarp is differentiated into outer epicarp, middle mesocarp, inner endocarp. When that differentiation is present, that fruits are called fleshy fruits. When you take in mango, epicarp and mesocarp, mainly mesocarp is fleshy and edible. In mango, mainly edible part is mesocarp, especially endocarp is stony. When stony endocarp is present, that fleshy fruit is called drupe. For drupe, another example is coconut. You just observe in the coconut, epicarp is leathery, mesocarp is fibrous, endocarp is stony. What is the edible part in coconut? Clearly, endosperm. Endosperm is the edible part in coconut. So these are fleshy fruits. Whereas when you go to dry fruits, In the dry fruits, there the pericarp is not at all differentiated into outer epicarp, middle mesocarp, and endocarp. Clearly, there only pericarp is present. That is dry fruit. These dry fruits are three types again: dry dehiscent, dry indehiscent, schizocarpic. Once again, dry dehiscent, dry indehiscent, schizocarpic. First, we are going to dry dehiscent. Dry dehiscent fruit, example, you take dolichos. So that is the dolichos. You just look at there in the dolichos. The fruit can dehiscence yet maturity. These fruits dehiscence, these fruits splits at maturity and liberating the seeds. When the fruits dehiscence at maturity and liberating the seeds, then that fruits are called dry dehiscent fruits. Example, dolichos. When you go to dry indehiscent, example, variza or wheat. In variza sativa or in wheat you take, there the fruit never dehisces even at maturity. The seeds are liberating only after disintegration of pericarp. So the seeds are liberating only after disintegration of pericarp, hence they are called dry indehiscent. And the third one, schizocarpic fruits. Schizocarpic fruits splits both in dry dehiscent manner as well as dry indehiscent manner. How? It is an interesting point. Dry dehiscent, it means the fruit dehisces and liberating the seeds yet maturity. This is the point. So like that, when you take acacia, the fruit, look at there, that fruit splits into small bits yet maturity. Those bits are called mericarp. So fruit is splits into small bits, those bits are called mericarp, that is the dry dehiscent character. Then the seeds are liberating after disintegration of pericarp of mericarp. After disintegration of pericarp of mericarp, that is called schizocarpic fruit, example, acacia. Thank you.